wasn't me.
It's a great title. Trailer slick.
Yes, Johnny.
Hello, hello.
Ah, shit!
That thing has got to be delivered to the master, wherever it is, whoever finds it first, unopened.
How much you want for it? We don't want to see. We haven't heard. And we shall not speak.
Just how did you possibly get into this organization?
My uncle.
Julian, I don't care.
And if it's a bomb, then that's a lot of casualties.
This is Dawna Heising for MoreHorror.com, and I'm here with Ron Gilbert. Well, you have a great look. I'm so excited to be interviewing you.
Oh, thank you.
Can you tell me about your profession?
Well, I started out in New York City. I studied, I'm a member of the Actors Studio, so I studied with Lee Strasberg, and I knew De Niro, Pacino, all the guys before they became who they were, Hoffman, and start out there, and then was up for the role of Michael in The Godfather, and it's a true story. But what happened is they cast Al, and they liked me so much that they made me the tallest usher in The Godfather.
Oh.
And I have a strange life. I lived on a farm in upstate New York. I got involved with the Whole Earth movement, and came out to California, and I've worked in, the films I've done, I've done all the TV shows, Cold Case, Desperate Housewives, NYPD Blue, I did Usual Suspects, and one of the people involved in the organization, Christian Filippella, I did a film with him a little over a year ago called Silver Case, and I played, my character, my interpretation was Adam Sandler stoned.
Okay.
And the only way I could play the guy, and but I also, I've worked in Italy. I opened two schools, acting schools. One was Actors Academy Milano. The other one was Acted Mething Studio.
So, do you speak Italian?
I speak enough to get in trouble. But I don't, it comes and goes. It's like I worked in Mexico for a year. I wrote a telenovela. Uh-huh. And I was speaking a lot of Spanish. And then now and then, it flips back and forth. So I just have to brush it up. When I'm in Italy, I know all the numbers and I know all the things and I know how to get in trouble, and we know what to say. But I mean, I love Italy. You've been to Italy?
No,
you're
kidding. No, I'm probably the only person who's never been there, but I love Italy.
You should go. They'd love you. You'd be like a big hit.
Well, I want to be there soon.
The next Anita Ekberg, right? I mean, we could do La Dolce Vita again. I've been there, and actually I do coverage for films, so I was there, I was there last year in Milan just to do some, a friend of mine does the Milano International Film Festival.
Uh-huh.
You know Andrea Galante?
No, I don't.
He may be here tonight. He does a nice thing, and then I did cover the Rome Film Festival, which I love.
And what are you doing here tonight?
I'm here tonight because I produce, distribute, and I put things together. I have two projects that I've been trying to do in Italy. One with Marco Benigni and another one with Eros Pugliali, and we're trying to do it's a kind of a horror thriller.
Uh-huh.
And then another film about, I call it the sperm movie. It's about two Italian guys and they meet two girls in America and they wind up, going back to the village, which is the village where my grandparents came from, Albano di Locania. It's in Basilicata region in the south. It's a little village on top of a mountain.
Okay, and you're Italian and Jewish,
Italian,
right?
Well, I'm Italian Catholic, but the Jewish part we can click into. My father was a Russian Jew.
Okay.
And a week ago we did a play called Mr. Dago, which is about Italian Jews coming to America. And it was with Renee Taylor, Joe Bologna. And mm-hmm. We're trying to do a production probably in October.
Okay, well, what side do you feel closest to? It sounds like you do a lot with Italy.
Chinese right now.
Okay.
I mean, you're wonderful. You have such a wonderful way about you that you're so easy, you're so receptive.
Oh, well, thank you. Well, actually, I do know some people who were involved with the case, or Silver Case.
Oh, really?
Yeah, Val Tasso and Kelvin Hanyi.
I worked with Val in the film.
Okay, tell us about that film. How did it get made, and how did you get involved?
You know, Christian had wanted me to be involved in the film because I sort of have a reputation of, oh, Ron will come in, he'll do this. So,
and he knew you from a previous film?
Never met him. Met him, somebody told me to meet him, and the next thing I know is I get called to play one role, and then they call me up and they say, Ron, hi, you have to work tomorrow. And I said, it's going to be a little problem. They say, why? I said, because I'm in Rome. And the film was happening in Los Angeles. So we didn't get, then I met them again last year at the Cinema Italian Style they have here. And then he said, we're going to work in 2 weeks. And they called me about a day before. And then we went and did the film and in a beautiful villa in Latigo Canyon. I mean, this is beautiful.
But yeah, this is amazing.
I mean, we're lucky to be here. So they know that I'm involved in the film. Yeah, I can help maybe bring something to the film, maybe do distribution, maybe help to bring some financing, some stars.
What was your role in the film?
My role in the film is a really offbeat guy who comes into the house. They have a silver case that they need to open. But since I'm a little confused, I'm a plumber. And I come in to open the case with a plunger, and I brought my own plunger.
Okay.
And we had a lot of fun. It's the funniest role in the movie. Everybody would see them. So I'm trying to help him get the distribution on the film. You know, he did it very great quality. Eric Roberts is in it, some other people. Mm-hmm. But they're just trying to, you know, like any other film, trying to get to festivals and trying to...
Wasn't it at the Cannes Film Festival?
It was at the camp. It was there, and then it was also the Rome Film Festival.
Oh, okay.
And I think it was in Fort Lauderdale. Recently. I just talked to Christian the other day. He should be here tonight, hopefully.
Okay, and how do you get involved with distribution?
What happened is I used to program film festivals and would always meet filmmakers and they needed distribution and I happened to have some contacts and the next thing you know we were putting films in theaters and then doing DVD and foreign, you know.
Okay.
Yeah.
And how did you get involved with the financing? The same way? Because
because you meet someone that has money, and then, like, you know, the money, sometimes they don't have the money, but it's entertaining. As long as you don't get stuck with the bill, you're okay.
Okay. So what's your favorite thing to do since you do so many things?
Talking to blonde women on a couch.
No, I mean acting, producing.
I mean, I like them all. I mean, I really prefer the acting, but I like to be involved in the creative process. I like to help the, you know, when I get involved in the film as a creative producer, I like to make sure the actors are where they should be and then also bring talent to it. And it's like being a maitre d' in a good restaurant and making sure everybody's happy.
Okay, and what's your next project?
Well, my next project is, we're trying to do Capture with Marco Benigni and there's a couple of things I'm trying to do with another partner of mine, Mark Holden. We have a couple of, but you know, until the financing comes in, you're floating.
Okay. Is that the hardest part always, to get financing?
Usually.
For you.
You know, it's, you know, you can get people committed, but the thing is, the market now is really tight. So you have to make sure that you, and you know, you can cut corners and stuff. We were supposed to do a film in New Orleans. We're supposed to be doing it this month, and the Italian money never showed up. It's sitting in a bag somewhere in Naples.
Oh, actually, yes. Yeah, so the worldwide condition has affected the film.
Yeah.
Oh, especially Italian and
Italian. I mean, look at the Greeks.
Oh, yeah.
You know, China's getting a little affected. They're not showing it as much. I mean, France is getting, our rating has dropped, you know. You know, so
okay.
It's...
Well, do you expect to see a turnaround this year or next year?
Well, yeah, I'm very optimistic. There's always something going on because I also work as an actor, so I do commercials. I just did a commercial for Sissy's Pizza playing a mafia guy who's a vampire.
Really? Oh, can you give us a demonstration?
Just the teeth. And you have to go like this. It's kind of funny. And the nice thing about it, the makeup girls had done the makeup for the film The Artist. Yeah, usually when you do a commercial, you have very high-level production people.
Yeah.
So it's a lot of fun. So
yeah, I know. The commercials are big money. Wow, The Artist was great.
Oh, The Artist. The Artist is one of my favorite films. I mean, I think they're really going to win.
You do?
Oh, yeah.
Over the help?
And the dog, I mean, well, I love Viola Davis. I really wish that Viola wins because I think she's brilliant. And she has so much. And I know that Octavia Spencer is going to win Best Supporting. Mm-hmm. And I know, and I really feel strong about Christopher Plummer winning. But the artist has a very good shot to win Best Film.
Yeah, it does.
You know.
Well, thank you so much for visiting with us.
Okay.